Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as Tube 87. Today I'm going to do a study, lesson, teaching about friends and worldly associations. So that includes the world. Scripture speaks a lot about this, and it tells us how we are to deal with this, especially if we're claiming to be believers. And let me say this. Everything that I do on my channel, I'm talking to people who are working on, claiming, wannabe believers. Now, people of the world can watch it, but that's where the disagreement comes from. So, you know, people of the world are free to turn away if it doesn't affect them. If it affects you, it affects you. But let me say that to say this. However I'm inspired, I'm going to teach what I teach to help individuals, to give guidance, because the Father's word, and he commands it of us. He said to go out into the world and teach all nations. So we ought to be out here teaching his word, bringing souls to him. And my way of doing this is how I openly rebuke or chastise or point out or reprove issues that I see based on whatever. Now, a specific individual could do something, and then next thing I know, the Holy Spirit comes to me and says, Lloyd, do that. And it leads me to Scripture. If I see someone do something, I don't associate everything with a particular Scripture, but when the Holy Spirit comes to me and says, there you go. And has me going all over the Scriptures, finding all these Scriptures and putting together a study, a lesson that many of you can use and relate to, I'm going to do it. We are to rebuke in love. We're to point out these things, but we're to do it in love and meekness. And this is how I do it. See, it's ambiguous. It's for everyone. And to the individual or individuals that it applies to. So take my message given to me by the Father, his word, and run with it as you may. We should all be running with it in one direction or another. So I'm going to continue to openly rebuke out of love. Proverbs 8 and 9. Let's go there. Let me read it. Proverbs 9, verse 8. It reads, it says, reprove not a scorner, lest he hate you. Rebuke a wise man, and he will love thee. Give instruction to a wise man, and he will be yet wiser. Teach him a just man, and he will increase in learning. So, what that is saying, it's clear to me, but I'm going to break it down even more. What it is saying is, don't try and rebuke someone who hates the Father. Don't try and rebuke someone that's of the world, because we all know when you try to tell someone or teach someone of the word, and they're straight out of the world, they will attack you, they will curse you, they will shut you down. This is what it's saying. Don't try and correct a scorner. They're going to hate you anyway. But if you're rebuking someone that is of the Father, and that means working on it, struggling or whatever, they should embrace that. It says that a wise man, it will increase his learning. You give instruction to a wise man, and he will yet be wiser. Teach a just man, and he will increase in learning. So, even though when someone rebukes us, chastises, corrects us, points out something that is against the will of the Father, it feels like we need to defend ourselves. And that's where we need to subdue self and listen. It's not about self. See, I don't have a problem rebuking anyone, but I'm careful about who and what and how I say it to them, because people aren't trying to hear it, because now they get defensive. But see, if you're doing it coming from the Father's word, just do it and let them deal with it, but do it in meekness and in love. Look, go with me to Proverbs 27. And we're going to read verses 5 and 6. 27, 5 and 6. 5 says, open rebuke is better than secret love. So, you know, rebuke someone openly. Don't just, if you claim you love them, don't just not rebuke them. That's you're letting them fall. We are not to let people fall if we love them, but we have to do it in meekness and love. Remember, the Father's word says to do everything in meekness and in love. If we claim to be a believer of his, that's how he did it. Verse 6 says, faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deceitful. If you are the friend of someone, if you love someone, you wound them. You wound them with that chastising, with that correction, because you know it's going to wound them, it's going to hurt their feelings and all these things. But don't not do it. That's being secretive about your love for them. That's not showing love. Show them you love them. Rebuke them. We do it with little children all the time. If a little child does something wrong, we openly rebuke them, chastise them, correct them, because we love them. So why do we stop when individuals become older and grown adults? Because we don't want to hurt their feelings. We don't want them to get mad at us or angry with us and say things they shouldn't say. If they go that route, it just shows where they are. See, when people react, it displays and illustrates who they are. It displays their character. But don't let that stop you from doing the Father's will. Don't not love them. Openly rebuke them. Show them you love them. Say, look, I love you, but what you did is wrong. You can't do that. The Father's word says not to do that. You will suffer for doing that. Show them in the word. Tell them in the word how much you love them by rebuking them. See, the thing is, if they're a true believer, they will get up when they stumble, especially if they stumble and you chastise them out of love. They will get it. They'll be down and hurt, but they will get up. But see, a wise man will always gain wisdom from that shortcoming, or from any of his shortcomings, and he'll be restored. See, You can't learn anything if you don't stumble and get back up. If you fall and you stay down there, you just stay down there and you're learning nothing. If you get angry and mad and fight people off, are you a true believer? Because rebuking people is extremely important also. And we have to do it out of love. And it's up to them to get up from their own stumbling. So with that being said, remember, this is Brother Lloyd, a.k.a. 287. And remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. It's 287. I'm out.